Hello everyone, Rex here, and welcome back to more Let's Play The Legend of Zelda The Wind Waker HD, where today we're going to do a tiny bit of more side quests, but at the end of this episode we will be placing all three of the pearls. Now, for our side questing, we're actually going to go ahead and start by sailing over one tile northeast of Windfall Island here, and we're going to open one of our treasure charts, namely treasure chart number 11, and that means that a bit to the southwest of our next island should be some treasure. Now we should see it. Yep, there we go, there it is, big thing there. There's also a fish, so we will be talking with the fish momentarily. Right here should be good. There we go. And we're gonna start off the episode already with some salvaged treasure. Pretty good start to the episode, I think. And it is a piece of heart, once again, creating another heart container. And that means that we now have two rows filled, which is pretty cool. Now, on this island itself, we can find two choo-choos, which is pretty cool, first of all. We're going to go ahead and take you out and also take your choo jelly, because it is rare. So, I like trying to get their choo jelly. Plus, they do drop yellow rupees, and we've been spending some cash. Now, let's open this chest. And that should get us a treasure chart. So, yeah, another one that we can relatively easily pick up. You don't even have to do anything special for that one. Let's go ahead and feed the little fish that's over there. And right over here, we have Crescent Moon Island. Looks like a crescent moon, indeed. You'd best be careful sailing these waters on nights when the moon is full. Well, if you like pure soul-freezing horror fry, then maybe you can handle it. And that's all the info I've got to offer. Horror, huh? Well, I think we'll avoid that. And since it is looking stormy, I'm gonna just sail off. And we're gonna go one more tile to the west. To the east. And before I do that, I'm gonna put in some more bait, just so I can have it. But yeah, I'll see you guys over one tile east. Actually, hold that thought. On the Crescent Moon Island tile, if we actually go to the northeast corner here, there is another submarine. Almost forgot about this one, but then I remembered. So, we're gonna go ahead and go in here first. And if we go down here, only one mini blind? Well, that's easy. Huh. That was super easy. No. No such luck. A bunch of these guys will show up. And they are annoying to take out. Oh, the slowdown there was bad. Yeah, when a lot of these enemies show up, slowdown can sometimes get pretty bad. Boom. Ah, it just feels so good to spin attack a bunch of them. Come on, spin attack. It causes so much slowdown, but it's so fun to do. But yeah, there's gonna be a lot of these mini blins showing up consistently. You will take some damage here, or I tend to take some damage. I'm just bad at defeating armies and armies of mini blins. There might be a good way to deal with them, but I don't know of it. Especially when Link sometimes just won't keep swinging his sword in, like, attacks. Like, he'll do a combo, but then he won't hit anyone in some moves, and it's just unfortunate. Well, the ladder dropped down, so that's good news. I think we have pretty much all of them dead. There are some left, though. Come on. But it doesn't really matter. You don't have to defeat all of them, just enough to drop the ladder, I guess. And that's all I care about. So let's go ahead and get ourselves another treasure chart. And I'm gonna get out of here because I just don't want to deal with these guys. They are annoying to deal with. We took a lot of damage there, but I'm not too worried because Well, we'll be finding a piece of heart this episode that will just heal it all straight up. Now let's go ahead and sail one tile east like I was planning. And this tile here has the name Seven Star Isle. If you see seagulls flying around some of the sea waters, that's a sign you need to be wary, Fry. Because the seagulls flock to wherever Big Octus appears. Big Octus, I tell you, those things don't matter around. That's all the info I've got to offer. Huh, seagulls, huh? Well, actually, if we go to the southwest-ish portion of this tile, we should indeed be able to find one of those seagull flocks. Yep, right over there. We can see it. And yeah, we are not afraid of any big octos. We're gonna go ahead and mess around with it. So let's get out our cannon here as it comes up from the depths. And again, we're gonna go ahead and shoot its eyes out with the cannon. And again, if you still haven't taken a picture of this thing, just take a picture of it, damn it. This might be the last time that I warn you. But yeah, we're gonna go ahead and shoot out its eyes. Of course, boomerang still works as well. If you run out of bombs, you might have to switch over. It's just that boomerangs take 3 hits per eye, bombs take 1 hit per eye. If you waste bombs, then it might take more, but eh. Generally, I do good enough with bombs that I'm okay wasting some. And there we go. Relatively easy, and another big octo bites the dust. And sinks down the bottom. So let's salvage up their remains. Put this away. I think here is the spot, and it is. Nice, nice. It's another piece of heart, and that fills up our entire thing. So that's pretty cool. Next up, I think we actually want to head... we want to head southeast one tile. So we're going to go past Dragon Roost. We're going to skip that. If you have 20 golden feathers, there is something you can do on Dragon Roost Island. And if you really stole a lot from the Piets in the second dungeon in the Forbidden Woods, then you might have it. But I didn't steal enough from them, so I only have 10. So I'm going to go ahead and save that for later. And we're just going to go southeast one tile and do what we want to do there. And right over here, we have the flight control platform. To the west of here, over on Dragon Roost Island, you'll see all kinds of rocks. Big ones, little ones, you get the picture. Anyway, they say that long ago, there used to be treasure hidden inside those things. Who knows, there may be still some left. You should open your eyes and take a good look around. From as high up as the sun to as low down as your toes. So, yeah. We'll have to check some rocks over on Dragon Roost at some point. But that is something that we'll save for later. What we're actually going to do is we're going to go ahead and go up here if we can exit out. And we have a special game over here that we can do. Birdman Contest signing counter. You think you were born to fly? Take the challenge of the sky to win fame and prizes. Before doing this, change your wind direction. You want to make sure that the wind is set northwest. So it already is for me. But good to check. If your wind isn't set northwest, make sure it is. Also, grab your Deku Leaf. You're gonna need it. Also, can we get some free rupees? Please? Okay, that's fine. Greetings, O person who is sure to come to take the challenge of the big sky. This is where you can register for the official Rito Tribe Birdman Contest. Now listen, you're free to use any means, methods, or tools you have at your disposal to help you soar through the sky. The rules are simple. See how far you can fly before you crash into the roiling seas like so much deadweight driftwood. Banner stands now at the site where the great and talented champion who has flown the farthest to date crashed into the frothy waves in a massive splash of glory. If you're able to pass that flag, then you will be the new champion and you will be drenched in praise much as you will be drenched in seawater. Participation fee is merit 10 rupees. I will. Okay, up the ladder you go. My brother waits you up top. You don't seem to have any wings or feathers on your back. So do you have something that you can use to fly, right? I sure hope so. Here's wishing the wind beneath your thing, whatever it is. So yeah, our goal is to get past that banner up there. Ah, challenger, the contest is afoot. You see the banner that far up in the distance? That marks a great record set by our great and talented champion. You must pass that banner. So yeah, we must pass that banner. And these spots will contain magic. You're gonna need the double magic meter for this. If you don't have the double magic meter, don't bother. So basically there are some cyclones and you want to hit those cyclones. You can skip this first one because I think it's too low anyway. But other than that, you are gonna have to hit all of the cyclones or you will end up in seawater. So come on, let's make sure we touch this one. Oh man, that is unfortunate. That is so unfortunate. Okay, we still got it, but that cost us a lot of magic. I'm not sure if we have enough magic left now, because that didn't go as smoothly as I wanted it to, and I'm afraid we're gonna run out of magic. I think you can skip that second one or that third cyclone as well, but yeah, we're gonna run out of magic now. Damn, that's unfortunate. Let's do that again. Sploosh! Flight distance 199 yards. A whopping 199 yards. Well, let's do that again. Okay, this time, let's make sure we actually hit our cyclones. That is, pretty damn important. If you get screwed out of taking a cyclone and you have to go back for it like I did, then that will screw you up bad. Oh, come on! What is with this cyclone? This cyclone literally hates me. It hates me, I tell you, it hates me. Okay, we got a small boost from the first one. I'm just gonna head a lot left because I keep missing this one because it wasn't far enough left. There we go. That's the stuff. That's what I'm talking about. This time we actually hit that, and that is definitely good. We're gonna hit this one too. Boom. Get a nice boost again. Can we hit this one? I think we might be allowed to skip this one, but I'm not sure. Yeah, we should be fine now, actually. We should be fine and make it past it. Just barely, though. Your magic will run out. Oh, my. Did I make it? Sploosh. 251 yards. Is that the record? Really? Wow, that's some great flying, but not quite great and talented. What? That must have been like a yard short. Dang. We're doing this again. There we go. This time we got it. Now we should be able to make it. Now we should be able to make it. Will you give me a boost? No, you will not. That's okay. That's okay. We should have the height, actually. We should have enough height. Oof. Do we, though? Yes, I think we will. Just that one cyclone, I think, is just barely enough height. And if we keep going straight, we should make it. No, see, go down. Ooh. Well, that should be further. That should be past the flag. Right? Go! Congratulations! Your current record is an impressive 260 yards. Breathtaking. You've shown me an incredible feat of aerial navigation. My eyes, they are unworthy. Whew, we did it. Amazing. You blew past my brother's best record in impressive fashion. You would make a fine and distinguished member of the Rito tribe, I guarantee it. The former champion upstairs says so too. You're both great and talented. As new champion of the Birdman contest, please accept this great and talented prize. And we get another piece of heart. Come back anytime you feel the desire to fly again. I shall wait with one eye on the sky and the other on the sea. Thanks. Unfortunately, we are pretty out of magic now. Pretty tapped out, but hopefully we'll pick some up later. Our next destination, actually, is gonna be one tile to our south. So, I'll see you guys there. And right over here, we have the Starbelt Archipelago. Is that the way you pronounce it? I don't know. I wouldn't sail through these seas on nights when the left half of the moon is missing. You'll regret it if you do, Fry. I'm warning you, not my fault if you get so scared you can't go to the bathroom at night anymore. That's all the info. Another tile where apparently scary stuff happens when the moon is at a certain time. But what we're actually going to do is go over to that platform. Also, you might notice my rupee count is different. Yeah, I decided to go ahead and salvage up, well, one of these things. Because, well, I figured I kind of could use that after how much I spent on things. Come on, get out of here, you. Get out of here. Can we defeat you with a bomb? Yeah, we can. Brute as flying things. I'm actually gonna go ahead and just climb the platform. I don't think we need to really bother with all of the cannons on the side. What? Ah, it can be. I do dislike getting on these ladders because Link's collision detection sometimes is a bit wonky with it, because you want to be able to swim past it, but sometimes you don't want to swim past it and you want to swim up it, and I don't know, that can be tricky. We are gonna go ahead and get a bunch of joy pendants from these guys, is what I was gonna say, and I stand by that. So let's go ahead and take you out. Did I steal from you? Yes, I did. Then I can safely open this chest, because we of course still need to collect more joy pendants, so yeah, we're going to do that. But here we go, we get a treasure chart here on this thing. Let's fill up our magic a little bit. No, not really. Well, very slightly. Oh well, that's fine. Let's go ahead and head to our next destination, and that is 2 squares west. So see you guys over there. And the island we are on now is called Eastern Fairy Island. That's right, we're gonna get another upgrade. Word is they hold an auction every night on there, over there on Windfall Island. Every night the people gather in the Hall of Wealth to amuse themselves by spending a little money. Ah, they're rich. Auction may be a race to see who can bid the highest, but I'll let you in on a little secret. The key to winning an auction is to be both patient and bold. I'm serious, Fry. From what I hear, they get some great things up there. The auction block too, like an extra fast sale among other things. Maybe that's just a rumor. You should try it out, Small Fry. You might just like it. Well, yeah, we actually won that extra fast sale there. And his advice is good. If you actually wait until the end and then make a really bold high bid, then that nets you some pretty good rewards. So if we're gonna go ahead and come over here, we can notice that there's another big old boulder here. So we're gonna break that open. Also another one of those withered Deku tree guys. But again, I'm saving those for a bit in the future. Let's go ahead and get our upgrade. Plus we can get our magic restored, which is pretty nice. I could do with some more magic restoration. Young Waker of the Winds, allow me to aid you in your quest. Please do. we get an even bigger bomb back. That's right, we can now carry a maximum of 99, and that's the final bomb upgrade that we can get. Of course, you can pick up fairies. I don't need any fairies right now. So, next up, we're actually gonna go ahead and head one more tile to the west, because that is actually the first place where we're gonna place one of the three pearls. That's right, we have now come to the point where we are gonna place our pearls. So, let's head over one more tile to the west. And this first island is Northern Triangle Island. Also, hi Octorok. Let me tell you something, Zofri. The school in the Windfall Island has one gorgeous teacher. But the thing is, the gang of four little hoodlums is always causing trouble. So little delinquents like to cause all sorts of trouble. They go climbing trees and hiding behind buildings instead of going to school. What a bunch of savages. Somebody's got skull dust scoundrels to set them straight for the sake of the poor teacher. You hear me, Fry? So yeah, he basically gives you a hint to set those kids straight if you never ended up doing that. Also, watch out. There is that big thing over there. That big cyclone. And you don't want to get swept up in that. At least, not if you want to stay here. And if you want to reach Eastern Fairy Island, head east from here. So they kind of give you a tip to that. That is a good tip. But we just came from there. So instead, we're going to go ahead and place the first of our pearls. Wandering traveler who seeks the guidepost of the goddesses. Place the pearl you hold here. And what we place here is the first pearl that we got way back at Dragon Roost Cavern from Prince Kamali. Our dragon pearl, the Dins Pearl. Or Dragon Ball. Two pearls remain. And, well, that is actually where we're gonna head. We're next up, we're gonna head to the other, or to the second pearl. So, I will sail over there and see you guys. And we're gonna go over to the eastern island. So, that's a little bit to the east. Two tiles to the east, one tile south. And here we go, Eastern Triangle Island. We already filled this in on our map before. But let's go ahead and place our second pearl. Wandering Traveler, yep, we'll place a pearl. We heard that text already, it's the same. Glowing eyes, it's so cool. I love that glowing effect and how dark it gets. It's really cool. But this is Faror's pearl that we got in the Forbidden Woods. Only one pearl remains. So we're gonna go ahead and place that pearl as well. However, we are gonna do some side questing along the way because it's just so, so convenient. So we're gonna go ahead and move one south first to get another little prize. All right, here we are over on Bomb Island. There is one of the merchants there, but we're not gonna deal with that merchant right now. We're just gonna go ahead and actually go ahead and blow up this bomb here, or this boulder with our bomb and create another hole. And we didn't mean to do that. I meant to roll down here. And inside here, we actually have a small mini dungeon. There's a switch here. Opens the door. You get off it. Door closes. So, what do we do? Well, we get ourselves... I wanted to say we'll get ourselves a nice little weight, but then it had to go ahead and drop itself into the lava root-like. Sometimes they're just not considerate for me. But yeah, just place it on the switch and move on. A lot of fire around. Let's go ahead and actually move over here. Really? You had to jump over it, Link? That was your brilliant plan. Come on now, that was not my fault. That was definitely not my fault. Because Link decided to just jump over it. Step on the switch, the fire goes away. And it actually stays away, I think. So, yeah, that is pretty good. Just stupid that Link jumped there. That was not on me. go ahead and push you out. Or do we need to kill you guys? Maybe we do. Maybe we need to kill them, because there's nothing else that we can really do. Although, there's probably a switch in that hole that we need to do. Yeah, in retrospect, that actually makes a lot of sense. So we're gonna go ahead and do that. Oh, come on, you're in the way. Okay, well, I'm gonna throw you. Hopefully, yes. It falls on top of the switch. That's great. That's what we needed. Oh, and the other switch is in there. Okay, well, go ahead and wake up. Come here. Because we need to throw you on the other side now. You know what? You almost fell off the edge. I don't want to deal with that trouble. So we'll go ahead and toss you on there. And that opens or gives us access to this treasure chest here. Which gets us one more piece of heart. We only needed one more to actually fill another heart container. Now, there are actually some that we can get. There are a few things, a few side quest things that I didn't end up getting. Now the reason for that is that simply, for one, some things required a lot of rupees and some things just weren't really on a convenient path and we would have to go way out of our way to do it. And also I didn't want to be too busy with side quests for too long, so it would have probably been another episode if we actually had gone and done that too. So that's why I opted to not do that. But now we're gonna go ahead and head west to Tiles and place our final pearl. So I'll see you guys in just a moment. Alright, we are here now at the Southern Triangle Island, location of our final pearl. Also, I could have filled in the one in between, but I chose not to. A famed pictographer lives to the north of here on Windfall Island. He's apparently real wise and talented in the ways of pictography. He's even said to have the legendary pictographs that he treasured above all other things. He keeps them hidden away in a secret safe, or they so they say. By the way, Small Fry, what exactly is a pictograph anyway? It's just a picture. I'll show you one sometime, maybe. But yeah, he tells you about legendary pictographs. That's something that you actually need for the Nintendo Gallery. You can buy them at him depending on the night's moon phase, but that's beside the point. Let's go ahead and actually place our final pearl with that guy right behind there. Rude. Personal space. Give me some, please. But here's the third pearl, the blue one, that we got from Jaboon not too long ago. It's Nehru's pearl. And once all three statues have been placed, some rumbling will happen. And Ling, you better jump! Huh? Oh, or not. I guess it was nothing. Weird, huh, Ling? Nothing happened at all. Oh! Poor Ling. But yes, some kind of spirit shows up. Boom! Shining beam of light. Boom! You're dead too! Fire beats grass! Grass beats water! And a giant glowing triangle forms on the water. Oh, it looks so cool. And right in the center of that triangle, we can now find a brand new island. That's right, this island is not there at all until you do this, which is really quite sweet. And Ling got smacked into a wall again. Poor guy. But here we have our next destination of our adventure. Hey, you wanna sail faster, buddy? Because, I kind of need you to be here. This tower, which the pearls of the gods have caused to appear, is a place that the gods of the ancient world prepared so they might test the courage of men. Only one who is able to overcome the trials that await here will be acknowledged by the gods to be a true hero. Only then will that hero be permitted to wield the power to destroy the great evil. Rexby, that which you must obtain now lies before you. You must believe in your own courage, which has led you to triumph over too many hardships you have faced. And you must triumph once again. You must rise above the trial of the gods. That's right. Right in here is the trial of the gods. This is such a cool moment in the game, I think. You know, just that it rises up from the ground. It's so huge, too. And we are here now, in this very section, and right inside lies our next challenge, a trial of the gods. We'll take it on next time.